In these uncertain times, we are committed to sharing information to help. California workers have new protections to help keep them healthy.
Reporter Adam Rakusin looks at the responsibility your boss now has and how it could bring transparency to ensure safety.
2 weeks into 2021 and things seem, well, a lot like 2020. But I assure you, some things are different. See, on January 1st, employees got a bunch of new protections in the workplace, many surrounding COVID-19. Let's focus on AB 685, which deals with COVID exposure, notifications, and violations.
As soon as there's indication of an exposure in the workplace, notice has to go out immediately within 1 day to all the employees who are in that work site who could have possibly been in contact with that exposure, so they can take precautions.
Aaron Olson is a San Diego-based employment lawyer. He says the new law also requires that employers report to the State Department of Public Health and local health officials when a COVID-19 outbreak occurs at the work site.
In line with giving them notice of the exposure, employers are also mandated to provide the employees with additional information about their rights of being protected against retaliation for reporting or getting COVID.
The reason that we had to introduce this is because we had lots of employers who were not notifying their employees when they had been exposed to someone who was positive for COVID-19. It seemed like it was common sense, but it wasn't happening.
California Assembly Majority Leader Eloise Reyes is the lawmaker behind the new protections.
How do you believe that this increased transparency in the state of California?
Well, I think clearly, if the employer is now required to notify the employee, they don't have to say who it was they were exposed to, because we want to protect other employees too. But now the employee has a right to make a decision what they're going to do.
While the law requires transparency with employees, there's still questions about transparency with the exact location of outbreaks. Los Angeles County gives you the locations of non-residential settings with three or more laboratory-confirmed COVID-19 cases, but they're one of the few. In most cases, San Diego County reports all details related to outbreaks except the names and addresses, saying exceptions to this are situations where there is an action the public needs to take to protect their health. In Santa Barbara County, officials say sharing workplace outbreak information is only valuable in circumstances in which there was a high risk of exposure to other persons.
We want to find the balance. We want to be sure that it goes back to the transparency. If there is an outbreak in your community, you want to know about it so you can protect yourself. We're not trying to shame somebody, because if there's an outbreak, it's not the fault of that company. But we do need to know where the outbreaks are.
Adam Rakusin, KSBY News.